Guess a Number. 4? Close, but not quite. Guess a Number was the first game I ever programmed, not exactly by myself, but with the help of a friend showing me QBasic. He went through some basic commands to grab the user input, store it in a variable, and then check it against a hard-coded number before giving the user a chance to try again or tell them they won. Hello, Turtles! I'm Tim Baudette, and today I would like to help developers just getting started with their adventures into game development. You might be wondering about the best place to get started. What language is easiest? What type of game should you make? What game engine should you use? What even is a game engine? I'll cover this and more, but first, who am I to be talking about game development? I got a bachelor degree in game design and development from Full Sail University before working in the game industry for more than 5 years. I helped create games like Rock Band 3, Darkest of Days, Monster High, and many more. 5 years ago, I began making my own games and released Accelerate while working as a software engineer. I've been living my dream job for the last year as I've been making my own games full-time since August 2021. All of that is to say I've been making games for a long time and kinda know what I'm talking about. I stream the creation of racing games as a business on twitch.tv/timbaudette to inspire and motivate others to chase their dreams while understanding the risks involved. I've helped a lot of people get started and avoid some traps I've noticed, and today I help you. What do you need? You won't need much to get started, but you will need the desire to make a game and probably an idea you want to create. It is likely your idea will be too big for a first project, but you can always find ways to make it smaller. For instance, if you want to create a large, open-world, multiplayer role-playing game, you might need to reduce the expectations and first start with a tiny world and get a single player moving. This will already be very challenging for a first attempt. Once you know how to make a player and move them around a level, then you can begin adding more features to work toward your larger idea. Small victories are great when learning, and this is one reason you'll find lots of advice to start with small projects. With a little imagination, you can choose small projects that work toward your bigger goal. If it is too difficult to break into smaller bits, then starting with some classics like Pong, Breakout, Snake, Asteroids, etc. is a very good place to learn problem solving related to creating video games. Finally, you'll need a computer, tablet, or other device with tools that help you make the video game. There are many choices available, and it doesn't matter where you start. Game Maker and Unity are great sources with lots of documentation and tutorials that can help you. If you've heard of other game engines or tools, those are likely good options as well. What is a game engine? A game engine is kind of like a kitchen, with all the appliances and dishes that help you cook a meal. In this case, a meal is your game. You come up with the recipe and ingredients to create a tasty dish, similar to ideas, art, and content, for features of your game. Most kitchens will have all the appliances you need, and the same applies with game engines providing the tools. Some tools will be better, and some worse, in different engines, but that doesn't necessarily mean the whole engine is better or worse than another. It may be harder to stir batter with a spoon than with a stand mixer, but you can bake a chocolate cake with either. Let's get out of the kitchen, since I can't stand the heat, and bring this discussion back to game engines. One of the tasks game engines help with is creating the visualizations to your content like 2D sprites or 3D models. This content is often created with software like Blender or Photoshop, though sometimes you can find or purchase art in packs that match your vision. For a first game, sticking simple is perfect. Whether simple means making it yourself or finding the art assets, just remember to limit the scope and celebrate the little victories. Unity has a well-known asset store which might provide a great place to dig through for inspiration. It also has a ton of tutorials and resources which can help a new developer, although there is plenty of older material as Unity has changed through the years, and this can be sometimes confusing. To make a 2D game without any programming experience, GameMaker might be a good place to start, with drag-and-drop scripts. Unreal also has this with blueprints, and there are so many other options, it might be overwhelming. There's also a lot of conflicting advice that one engine is better than another. But at the end of the day, just get started. You will hear a lot of opinions telling you that one engine is better than another, or that a programming language is worse than others, and so on. There may be some bits of truth, but trying to find the perfect language, engine, or tool to work with is rarely a good use of time. Just get started and dig into the problems of building your own game, as there will be many issues for you. If you feel the engine or tool is causing the problems, then remind yourself that other tools will still have issues, even if the current one is solved. Bringing this back to baking a cake, the hand mixer will reduce the amount of effort required to mix up the batter compared to a spoon, but it will also increase the chance of baking a cake that is tough rather than fluffy. That said, if you have absolutely no idea where to start, asking advice is a good thing, just don't get too overwhelmed. If you already have some notion of programming experience, I'd recommend Unity, Unreal, or Godot. These are the most used engines and have plenty of tutorials and examples around. GameMaker also has a lot of good examples and is a place I would suggest to start without any programming background because of the drag-and-drop visual coding. Visual coding reduces the headache of syntax while learning to think in code. That comes with a little bit of a caveat. If you enjoy the programming side of GameDev, it would be wise to quickly move away from the visual coding to increase your capabilities. In GameMaker, that would be the GameMaker language, GML, or C# for Unity. That said, you can and should continue with visual programming if it is solving your problems and you're not finding that much interest in coding. Perhaps art or design is more interesting for you. The tutorial trap. There is nothing wrong with using a tutorial, article, or video to get started on a problem or help find solutions, but there is a trap I've heard of and seen many fall into. Something you should be aware of. Many beginners have come to my stream complaining about how they have followed a lot of tutorials and still don't know how to make a game they want. Only following tutorials improves your ability to follow instructions rather than developing the problem-solving skills. If you never used an engine or made a game before, following a tutorial line by line to get some basic ideas is a great place to start. Once you've done that, tackle the problems for your game by breaking the problem down, like I discussed earlier. To make Pong, you need to add a ball. Then the ball needs to move. Then it needs to bounce off walls, and so on. Trying to solve each of these problems on your own is building the skills, which actually helps for next time, while following a tutorial doesn't require as much thinking. Challenge yourself and push through to find the solutions. It will be a struggle. It is going to be hard. That is how you know you are learning new things. Just stick with it, and you will get there. Art and content. In game development, there are many different roles and skills to learn, like programming, design, art, and music. Each of these can be broken into many further segments, and the rabbit holes never end. There are generally two ways to tackle this type of problem. Gain a little knowledge across each field, or dive deep to become a master of one. I became a master of programming with a little knowledge around the other fields. In case you don't want to spend your effort practicing drawing, modeling, sound design, or music composition, you can look around for already made assets to use. There are a few things to pay attention to, and one of the most important will be if it fits the vision for your game. If it doesn't match the style or vibe you want, then it would be best to keep looking. After finding the content you want to use, make sure to double check the usage rights. What you can do with the art or music depends on the license applied, and that license can change between free and paid versions. This often means that an asset may be acceptable to use in games for personal use, where you are learning and experimenting, but not for commercial use, where your game is available for players to buy. That may also include free-to-play games that have other forms of revenue sources, either in-game or donation. I am not a lawyer, but this area requires reading and paying attention to licenses. CCO and other Creative Commons licenses make this relatively simple to understand and standardizes the process. Just watch your back and always credit the artists who help even by contributing free assets. Final words of encouragement. Welcome to the world of game development. It is very exciting, fun, and creative. There will be many walls and there will be very challenging to deal with. This is learning and you just need persistence. If you can't go over the wall, try to go under it, or around it, or find a tool to help, maybe even a friend. It will be hard, but it will also become easier with practice. If you think I am full of success, you should watch my live stream where I can't even add numbers.
250 plus 250, that's 100.
I fail all the time. I just get back up again, learn from the mistakes, and move on. Remember that a master has failed far more than a novice has even tried. I've been working hard on Accelerate to the Tropics, where you can race around with an egg on top of your car. This game will be coming out at the end of March, so go wishlist it on Steam today. It is extremely challenging to drive fast and keep the egg safe, but you'll be rewarded with better ranks on the leaderboards to brag about to your friends. Finally, to support me for free, you can share this video with others, do the thumbs up or subscribing thing, and leave a question below. I may answer it in a future video. Until later, turtles, have a good one. Probably good. It's a wrap.
We did it.
Woohoo! Check out this video to see if smaller or bigger games matter.